Here's your WNEM-TV5 news update.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Blake Keller. Here's a look at the top stories we're following today. We're hearing from a Flint woman who says she was fired for refusing to falsify blood test results for kids exposed to lead during the Flint water crisis. She tells TV5 she was subject to a hostile work environment after refusing to lie, experiencing heavy scrutiny of her work and a coworker, triggering her severe allergic reactions twice. Recently, a jury awarded her $100,000 in a lawsuit about her time at the county health department. Well, a dog stranded on a Clare County island for more than a month is back on dry land. The story of Zaria and her efforts to rescue her have gotten a lot of attention. And we're happy to report, as of Wednesday afternoon, she is safe and sound. The Great Dane ended up on the island in August after running from her owners. Because she was so scared of people, rescuers set up a live trap using food as bait. Glad she's back. Kicking off today in Bay City, Hell's Half Mile Film and Music Festival. 4 days of independent film and music. The event starts tonight at 6 with the opening night party at the Pear Marquette Depot, where music lovers, film lovers, and filmmakers will join to share their passions and enjoy food and drinks. You can purchase tickets right now in the Hot Link section on our website. Here's Matthew, checking out your very first day of fall.
Yes, and our very first day of fall going to be a little bit cooler and also breezy too, so some pretty typical fall conditions. For today though, I would expect most folks to stay in the 50s during the daytime, so highs only up into the upper 50s for this afternoon. For tonight though, even cooler, we have lower 40s in the Thumb, but we have upper 30s for the Tri-Cities, also in Flint, but then in our northern counties, you can actually land near freezing by Friday morning. Something to keep in mind there, we could have some frost there by tomorrow morning. First 1-5 Sky Tracker shows our northwesterly wind. It's already kicking up some lake effect rain showers, and that'll be the case for today. Just isolated rain showers, so a lot of folks actually still end up staying dry. The best chance to see those rain showers will be in our typical lake effect bands up north in our northern counties and also the eastern shoreline of the Thumb. But once we head into tonight, we do start to see our clouds clearing out more farther inland, and that's why we see temperatures in the 30s for your Friday morning. 70 forecast is dry on Friday, 62, 65 on Saturday, 66 on Sunday. So still holding 60s into the weekend, but then even next work week, only starting off the week in the upper 50s, lower 60s, with scattered showers around Sunday and Monday.
Remember to tune into WNEM-TV5 on air and online 24/7 for the latest news, weather, and information.